Hi, everyone. I'm Rob Geada. I am the technical lead for Red Hat's TrustyAI team, and today I'll be talking about guardrails, what they are, why you might want to do them, and how they look inside of Red Hat's OpenShift AI. So first, let's take a look at what guardrails are. So in a normal unguardrailed generative model deployment, you'd have some model where users, you, me, anyone off the street that has endpoint access to the model, can send inputs through and get whatever it is that that model outputs back at them. So, for example, users could try to prompt inject the model to generate official company policy, and the model might say something that you absolutely don't want. Guardrails aim to fix this by moderating the kinds of interactions that users can have with the model. This is done by placing a modular set of detectors along the input and output pathways of the model, which can be configured to flag text according to whatever heuristic is relevant to your use case. So, for example, we might set up a detector to flag for possible prompt injection, which would then detect this input text as possible prompt injection and prevent it from being sent to the model. The same applies to the output. We might set up a detector to flag for unacceptable language, which would prevent this output from ever getting back to the user. Now, there are a number of benefits to guardrailing just beyond preventing the models from saying things you don't want. For example, it can massively save on inference costs, because your detectors can be orders of magnitude smaller than your generative model, right? They might be tens of millions of parameters instead of tens of billions. And so you can short circuit irrelevant or off-topic queries well before they ever hit your very expensive generative model. You could ensure that your model uses appropriate language for your use case. In something that's meant to be friendly and conversational, you might detect for overly ornate or overly formal language and ask the model to rephrase it, say, hey, can you say this a little more casually? And you might want to make sure that the model only talks about material that it's well informed on, right? That it only talks about subjects that it has the educational background to speak on with authority. You could do this by, say, performing a model evaluation, figuring out which subjects the model can answer really well and which subjects the model struggles on. Say, for example, you find that the model is really good at the humanities but struggles with science. You might set up a detector to identify which subject areas the model is being asked about and make sure that it only speaks on things that it has the authority to do so, the things that it has been proven to be able to answer effectively. So let's take a look at what guardrailing looks like inside of OpenShift AI. There are three main components. First is the guardrails orchestrator. This handles the network routing, the network requests of inbound from users, and then sends them out to the detector servers and the generative model as needed. It handles that flow. Next, we have the detector servers. These are contained microservices for those individual detection algorithms. So, for example, if we had a prompt injection detector that would live in its own server, if we had a detector to flag for unacceptable language or for, you know, is this a humanities topic that the model is being asked for, that would live in its own server. And finally, we have the guardrails gateway. This provides two benefits. First is it lets you preset specific pipelines of guardrailing. So you can say for preset A, use these specific detectors. Through preset B, use these specific detectors. You can have different detector pipelines depending on your specific use case. And it provides chat completion endpoints for each of those presets. The advantage of this is that you can then hot swap in different pipelines, different presets, and hot swap between unguardrailed and guardrailed models without having to change any of your API contracts. So this lets you experiment really quickly between different configurations and detectors, experiment with how does the guardrail model perform compared to my unguardrailed model? Does it flag up the right queries? That sort of stuff. It's really good for quick experimentation. And like I said, you don't have to change any of your API contracts. Now, the architecture of all of these inside OpenShift AI looks something like this, where the main entry point is through that guardrails gateway, where users come in through that chat completions endpoint. The guardrails gateway will then translate those requests into to the orchestrator, and the orchestrator will send them to the detector servers and the generative model as required. It'll then send it back to the guardrails gateway, which sends it back to the user. Now that we understand the components involved, let's take a look at a real-life OpenShift AI deployment of guardrails. So in this demo, let's imagine we are a highly successful lemonade stand, and we want to deploy a customer service agent for our prospective customers to ask us about our lemonade. We want two things. One, we want to make sure that all requests, all conversations are family-friendly and polite. And two, that our customer service agent does not promote our rival fruit juice vendors. To do this, we'll set up two detectors. The first will be a hateful and profane language detector, or HAP. The detector we'll use in this case is IBM's Granite Guardian HAP model. This is a small 38 million parameter language model that's designed to detect for hateful language, aggressive language, profanity, that kind of thing. We'll deploy this just like any other predictive model in OpenShift AI. We'll deploy it in kServe, which will let us query it, query specific text through it, and see does it flag for the various kinds of hateful language that the model is trained over. And second, we'll set up a regex detector to identify keywords from our competitors, things like apple or orange or pineapple, right? This will be set into the regex detector server, which is this little sidecar image that lives next to the orchestrator. This is really, really good for quick experimentation and for setting up lightweight detection algorithms, things like, does this word exist in the user input, that sort of thing. Now, if you want to see exactly how these detectors are set up and how they're deployed, I'm going to leave a link to the full code used in this example at the end of the video so you can go run this on your own OpenShift AI clusters. Now that we've got our detectors deployed, we need to configure the orchestrator to know about them, to know about all the different services that it needs to talk to and coordinate between. We do this by creating a config map that looks something like this, where we pass locations of the generative model and all of the detector servers that we care about, i.e. the hostname and the port of where these servers live on the cluster. Once we've created this config map, we can deploy the orchestrator, and then we'll have a full Guardrails deployment up and running that we can play with, that we can talk to and see how Guardrailing works. And so let's hop over to the command line and take a look. Here we are in my command line. I've got two variables set up here. One that points at my raw unguardrailed model. In this case, I've got it port forwarded to localhost. And the second points at the endpoint on my cluster of the Guardrails gateway. So the first thing I will do is I will ask that raw unguardrailed model, is orange juice tasty, to get an idea of its baseline responses here. And it gives me a well-reasoned argument as to why orange juice might be subjectively tasty. Next, we'll ask the guardrailed model the exact same question. And we do this just by substituting out that variable in place, and so we swap out the endpoints. And we might reason here that we set up that regex detector to flag for keywords of our competitors, so we might expect that this gets flagged as disallowed content. And that's exactly what we see. We see that the regex competitor detector picked up that word orange as forbidden. Now, let's ask the raw model to list some healthy fruit juices. And it gives us a lengthy list of healthy fruit juices. Perfect. Let's ask the same thing of our guardrailed model. And you'll notice here that we never say any of the forbidden words in the input. So the input should get to the model just fine. But let's see if this flags the output of the model for those forbidden words. And that's exactly what we see. We see output detections, that the regex competitor detector flagged in the output that the model generated those forbidden words. Finally, let's see if we can't get the hateful and profane language detector to flag some text by inputting some needlessly aggressive language into the model. And we flag that hateful and profane language detector because this was overly aggressive. It violates that sort of family-friendly environment that we wanted to set up with this agent. So this is a quick look as to the differences in how guardrailed and unguardrailed models work and how easy it is to swap between the two using the Guardrails gateway. If you'd like to run this demo on your own OpenShift AI cluster, I've left a link on screen that contains all of the code, all of the deployment files, so you can run this yourself. And if you're interested in learning more about us, contributing to our work, helping us out, I've left a link to the TrustyAI community GitHub. I'd love to see you there. So thanks so much for listening, and I'll see you next time.